Hi everyone, Nora here. So I'm just going to do a three-card angel tarot reading for you for this week. So here we go. So card number one, card number two, and card number three. So what have we got? So we have Justice, the Moon, and the Lovers. So the order they came out was Justice, Moon, and Lovers. Okay, so that's the order I will read them first. The first card you have is Justice. So it's very funny. A lot of people, when they get this card, they say, oh, there's going to be a court case. Everything's going to work out okay. You know, you're going to get justice for it. But when I've lived through my tarot, and I've been living through the tarot for 25 years, justice, the Justice card, always means the same thing to me. And that is what I tell the people when I'm reading it, because it usually has that sort of resonance with them. So justice is usually when an injustice has happened that we didn't see coming. Something that knocked us completely off balance. So something that, because we didn't see it coming, it really hurt or it really got to us. So when these things happen, they happen for a reason. So it could be a real unfairness that happened, or a shock or something like that. But then when we've actually come up off the floor, and when we've actually got up from this injustice and we've come through a few months, we get the Justice card again, and it's telling us that the reason that happened is because we would have just stayed in that place anyway. So an example would be, say you were in a relationship and you were giving 90% of yourself because you have a lovely warm heart, and you were giving 90% of yourself in this relationship. The other half was given 10%. You didn't realise that in the relationship because you were so in love, or you're so crazy about it, you know, this person or whatever. And one day they get up in the morning, they have a bag in their hand and they say, I'm leaving, I'm not happy. You did not see it coming for love nor money, because as far as you knew, everything was okay. But then after you've picked yourself up and you're down the line a few weeks or months or whatever it may be, you realise that person was always running away from things. And if you look back at that person's life, they were always running out when the tough, you know, things got tough, or when there was a bit of pressure, or when there was something they should grow into. So the universe is saying that your energy is much higher than that. And you wouldn't have left of your own accord, because you're the carer, you were nurturing this because you really like this person and you have such a beautiful heart. So when this happens, it just teaches us that we were giving too much of ourselves and we weren't getting enough back. So then when it's happened, you usually would find the right person, or you find out that you didn't need to be with someone to be whole. So just wait and see what happens, because you have the Lovers card coming as well. So this is the first one. So it's about whatever's happened, whether it be something that you have grown through now, or something that's only recently happened, to know that it's going to be okay, to know that it will come round to the right thing. The second one then is the Moon. Now the Moon is all about fear. So it's to release the fears that hold you back. So if you, for women mainly, when they're on a menstrual cycle, their cycle usually runs with the Moon. So what happens is we can be erratic around the Moon energy. We can dance around the Moon energy. You know, men too, their female side. But the Moon can bring fears. So things that haven't happened yet, we worry about. So they call that false expectations appearing real. That's what fear stands for. So it's telling you that if you let go of the fear is actually coming bigger than the actual event. So if there's something you're worrying about, especially to do with this first card, so it might be that you're left alone now and you're fearing how it's going to be for you, and you're not used to this place. Or it could be you're just fearing of what's going to happen next. To feel the fear and go forward anyway, it's all going to be well. So it's only fear that's making you feel anxious at the moment, so to let that go. So the last card then is the Healer, Archangel Raphael, in the Lovers card. So whenever you get the Lovers card, it's about relationships to do with love. So it's improved relationships to do with love. There's three of them. Okay, so the first one is if you're in a relationship at this exact moment, it's going to improve. If you're not in a relationship, you are your energy is getting ready to be in a relationship. You're getting ready. You're nearly there, you know. And the third one is about self-love and self-esteem and loving yourself, your inner child stuff, learning to love who you are. Okay, now, if you've had a knockback in the Justice card, yeah, and I'm not saying this is just emotional. This could be a work thing. It could be a family thing. But I'm just giving you the example of of emotions. So if something's happened and something's happened and it's split up and you didn't expect that to happen, it's bound to cause you fear. Okay, just try and let the fear go, because there's a reason this is unfolding in life for you. Okay, and then to let you know that there are improvements coming in relationships for you and in your own relationship with yourself. It's also improved health when you get the Lovers card as well. So if you're worried about any health issues, that too will happen. So now we're just going to read, there's always little messages on angel tarot cards. So I've read it to you as true tarot, which is the way I've always read tarot. So I read it as a tarot card would be for me. But there's also an extra little message here on each card. So I'm going to read that to you too, because it could resonate with you in other ways. So on the first card we had was justice. So we have, so this is what I was telling you about. It's going to happen now rather than then. Fair and just decisions. Also, do what you know is right for you. So don't do what you think others think you should do. Or don't do things to be accepted by others, or don't do things to make other people's life easier if it's making your life harder. So I'll say it again, do what you know is right, okay? And stand up for your beliefs. That's what's on the card. Yeah, so stand in your power, stand for what you believe in, and stand for yourself, yeah? So then the next one then, we have the Moon. There's a lot going on psychically around you, important psychic events going on. So a lot psychically is going on around you at the moment as well. So that could be why this massive change and shift has happened. Events behind the scenes. So there's things that are happening that you're not aware of that are leading to your spiritual growth. So just to be ready that everything's going forward for you. Release the fears that hold you back. Now, I mentioned that about the Moon, because the Moon causes us fear. So just release the fears that hold you back and just keep going forward. It's going to be okay. The Lovers card. Intimate relationships are coming. Carefully weigh up your decisions. Work out what it is you truly want. So if you've just come out of a relationship, work out what you will and won't accept in a relationship. You know, what do you deserve? A lot of people would say, oh, I just want somebody who's kind to me. I just want somebody who cares for me, or who doesn't shout at me. You know, we might as well get a dog if that's what you want. So what you want is to reach for the stars, because you deserve the best that best can be. So you want someone who's going to love and adore you. You want someone who gets up in the morning and worships the ground you walk on. Okay, we don't always get exactly that. But what we do reach for is what the universe hears we want. So if we say to the universe, oh, I just want someone who's kind. Your granny could be kind, you know. So that's all the universe thinks you want. So reach for the stars, know you deserve it, and be happy. So I'll do another reading for you next week, but love, light, and blessings. If you have any questions, just give me a text.